So what you want today? 2 days I gave some intro on science in slokas or science of slokas. There were few questions, but if you have anything very specific. Yesterday I casually mentioned about the Padal Padanugatam. Somebody loved it. I mentioned it in a different context, I think, right? As an exercise, don't run around the temple. Your concentration has to be there. Okay. But there is a great science behind circumambulation around the temples. Going around the temple, circumambulation. There is a great science. Yesterday what I mentioned was Padal Padanugadam Gache, or different text will have a slow, some small differences. Padal Padandaram Gatwa, another text says like that. It's all same. One step and the next step. Karau Chalana Vivarjidau Vajas Stotram. Instead of Studi, some places it is Stotram. Vaja Studi, Vaja Stotram, Hridit Dhyanam. Most important is in your Hridayam, Dhyanam should be there. See, it has got great science of concentration power. Whenever you do something, your attention, concentration has to be in that, not in something else. What is the purpose of going to temple? To do puja, to do prayer. So who has to be in your mind? Bhagavan. Why are you going to him? Because you trust him. What is your trust? He knows what I want. So don't go and ask, give a list of items what you want to Bhagavan. Bhagavan knows what you want. So don't ask anything to Bhagavan. A good bhakta bhakti is not asking something to Bhagavan, going for a purpose. That's why yesterday I said, when you go to a master, don't ask anything. Master knows what you want. But then, around that given something, you should have some questions. These are all traditional, not in a group of people with a heterogeneous group. There could be different, today somebody called immediately, asked, I have a 6-year-old. Do you know, average I get 10 calls every day asking their young children, 6-year-old wanted to learn slokas from me. I said, why? Because I missed the chance. Okay. You missed the chance, therefore you want your child to learn. Do you want to learn? No, I have no time. Right? You have no time. And what are your children doing? 2 o'clock finish class, by 3 o'clock she will go for music class, and 4 o'clock she will go for some other class. We will see how can we adjust to get. Okay, how much she learned? She finished all Bhagavad Gita 7 chapters by heart. Now she is not learning anything. Why after 7 chapters she is not learning anything? Why after 7 chapters not learning anything? Because 7 chapters was most boring. Why 7 chapters are boring? I told you this. I am not trying to teach here. I am trying to tell you the method of learning. Most of the people, they start with chapter 1 finished. It's so boring. The most boring chapter in Bhagavad Gita is chapter 1. Probably it would have put in chapter 1 so that, no, if you pass that hurdle, then you are half through. And what is there? Nothing great is there because Bhagavan himself is not opening the mouth. So nobody should start with the chapter 1, chapter 2. So where to start? How to look at it? See, if you are a smart person, you will not hit a stone 1000 times to break. 1000 times hitting a stone, it may not break at all. If you are smart enough, what you will do? You will look at every side and see where to hit. That ability to know where to hit for the stone to crack. That ability is most essential. When a book is given to you, people will take long time to study. Actually, it doesn't require that much time. If you know the trick of reading, trick of learning. So what am I trying to do here is only to give some tricks. Because we don't have time. Not every sloka is important. Every sloka is not at all interesting also. We told you 200 slokas written, then expand it. So there may be small version differences. There may be some different text explaining differently. Idea is to introduce something to you so that you find interest. Maybe your children also will find interest. When you have interest, definitely your children will have, if they are your children. If you don't have interest and you start forcing them to do, it will not work. Our eating pattern, learning pattern, everything is like that. If you have a lot of books at home, definitely children will be a reader. If you don't have library at home, you want your children to be readers? No. If you have a lot of gadget at home, definitely your children also will become. So that is essential. That is what is satsang. You should have people. Satsang need not be with the people today. You can have digital satsang also, right? What you play at your home is what your children will listen. So continuously listening, probably something will go inside. But if you are preparing them for a competition, that's a different matter. I don't know why do you make people to compete. I have not seen great dance competition winners become great dancers. Great dancers, probably the passion comes later also sometime. I've got good painters who does beautiful painting. The other day somebody from Thrissur who attended one of my camp, they wanted to send a big picture to me. I said, don't send it to me because why to send it to Hyderabad? I've got house in near to Thrissur. Send it to there. I have not seen. But what experience the person had staying with me in my home in Kerala, that is what the picture it seems. She said, don't take picture, don't see it in digital copy. When you come there physically, you must see. So it's all tied properly so that nobody can open it. That's how it has been tied. Given strict instruction only to be opened by Dr. DPS. Because they don't want that to be seen in the... See, that's an experience sharing. The passion should be there. The passion is there. I asked, where did you learn painting? No, I never learned painting drawing. It's not required. Learning is not required. Some trigger is required sometime. Maybe seeing some pictures, you get a trigger. Seeing somebody chanting a sloka, you get a trigger. There are a lot of information. Nobody need to. I don't think nobody need to learn chanting from somebody. Because it's all digitally available. Digital satsang is good enough to learn. But logically to think and understand, yes. So, vaja stuti. That happens. Hearing. Lot of times. You can repeat it. The stotram will come. Vaja stotram will be there. It becomes stuti only when you have hridi dhyanam. In hridayam, dhyanam should come. Concentration should come. Dhyanam is concentration. How do you get concentration? Only when you have interest. If you have no interest, concentration will not be there. Concentration is directly proportional to the interest. The interest is directly proportional to the way it is given to you. Maybe some nice packet is given for a product. Why is it a nice packet is required? Every soap can be put into white packet, right? They give colorful packets. Why? Because when it is given in colorful packets, people will like it. Yesterday I was telling, same rice, I mix a different carrot one day, beetroot another day. Why? That is because it looks beautiful. I was talking about the fashion yesterday to young students of fashion designing and all that on a journal program. I mentioned it also yesterday. Only one student asked me, sir, I also want to join. I have sent the link, they joined. And what is there, how the fashion can be shown, how you will make it product interesting, beautiful, how do you market, that was the question. So everything has to be dhyanam, attention, attention grabbing, concentration, focusing. That has to be there in whichever job you are doing. So when you go to temple, your attention has to be God. Evam guryal pradikshanam, that way you go. So this has got not only pradikshanam concentration. This is for learning the whole purpose of any activity which you do. The same thing Bhagavan told. Ananyaschintayanto mam yejana pariyupasate tesham nityabhiyuktanam yogakshemam mahamyam. I guarantee you success. Yoga kshemam. Yogam is joining. Kshemam is keeping it safe. We learn many things, but are we keeping it with us forever or are we forgetting? Kshemam means whatever you learn, keep it safe with you. Money, earning is good. How do you keep it safe with you? Fame, becoming famous is possible. How do you keep it safe with you? Today I was so happy. A student who attended my class in 2007 or 2000, maybe a few years back, many years back. She became a professor now. When she is teaching her MBA students, she wanted my help. So she was asking what can be done to make your children learn better. So we made a project plan together. So somebody comes back to us. Why I am able to, or somebody is coming back to me. That is important. Yogam is easy. You can grab a lot of people. You can send a message to many people, ask them to listen. But how do you make sure, or maybe how do you capture whatever money you have, how do you keep it safe? Whatever fame you have, how do you keep it safe? Whatever knowledge you have, how do you keep it safe? That's yogakshemam. Bhagavan says, yogakshemam I will guarantee only when ananyaschintayantoma. Continuously you must be onto that. So that continuation is through focus, dhyanam. Padal, padandaram, gatva, karau, chalana vivarjitau, vacha, stotram, hridhyanam, evam guryal, pradikshinam. This is, don't ask me whether it is science. This is more than science. Learning technique is a big science. So, science doesn't mean what gives you BSc, what can be experimented. Science in Bharatiya Shastram is called Shastram. Shastram is Lokanam Upakaraya. Whatever is useful for human being is called Shastram. So, here we are discussing Shastram but not science. Because we cannot write Shastram, we are writing science in slokas. So, it is something which is beyond science. Experientiable. So when you go to temple, what do you experience? Is somebody wanted to ask. Why do you go? Why do you go? To do namaskaram. Do you know how to do namaskaram? Is one first question. What is namaskaram? Yeah, doing like this. Go to God. Thank you. Bye bye. Tata. It is entirely different. I mentioned it one of the earlier sessions also, but then I left it. So because it's asked, again I have to come back. So what is namaskaram? Urasa, shirasa, vacha, your forehead, nose and lips. Manasa, why manasa? My chest, I cannot touch the ground. Right? So what is to be done? My Anjali, this is what is. And my drishyam, my eye have to go to ground. That means don't look here and there. While doing namaskaram, when you are doing prostration, lying down on the floor, don't keep your head here and there. Straight down. Nose has to touch, forehead has to touch, this part of the hand has to touch. Anjalina and drishya. Janubhyam, the tummy has to touch. And then Padabhyam, the padam has to touch. I don't know how many people do this. Pranamo Ashtanga Irinaha. Eight. You count this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Nabhi. 7. The bottom part of your legs and the toes. 8 part has to touch. That is namaskara. Urasa shirasa vacha manasa anjalina drishya janubhyam chaiva padabhyam pranamo ashta irinaha. And that is what is to be done in before God. And you can take a pradakshina. How many pradakshina? Beautifully explained. How to do namaskaram to Ganesha? Why do you want to do namaskaram to Ganesha, first of all? If you don't do that namaskara, except when you are pregnant, ladies also are supposed to do. So if somebody does like this and show, immediately ask, are you pregnant? I used to ask. Why? Doing like this? Yes, when you are pregnant, probably you cannot do all this magic. Otherwise, the world's best exercise. Yesterday somebody was asking yogasana, shirshasana, all that is not required. Asana is comfortably sit, that's it. So there is no shirshasana. You are nobody in this world except monkeys are comfortable putting the head down. So it is not asana at all. Asana is sukhasana. Sukhasana is asana. What is comfortable for you? Yeah, when you sit in a chair, easy chair like this, probably you are comfortable, but later you will become uncomfortable. So it's not temporary. Whatever Bharatiya Shastram says is not comfortable for some time. It is comfortable for longer time. So if at all exercise is prescribed, it's only one exercise which is the most best exercise, which is given as punishment when people don't learn mathematics traditionally. Every school teachers, in my childhood also I got. My children did not get, but then I asked them, this is what the punishment I used to get. You can also take it. It is good for you, for your good brain working, and you become intelligent. If mathematics you are doing bad, what that means? Your brain is not very functional. So what is the punishment? Make them functional. How do you make them functional? Hold your left finger like this, and then hold your right. I am showing it reverse because I don't know whether you are seeing reverse sometime. Hold it like this. Hold these two. Hold it like this. You could also try. Put it like this. Right? So your hands are crossed like this. And cross your legs. Now don't do that. But you can imagine that's how you should cross. And then this elbow has to touch the ground. Don't bend your knees. It's impossible for people after 40 if you have not practiced it. Don't try to do that and then crack your bones and then go to hospital. Not required. But at least your children should do it, so that where you have to do this? In front of Ganesha. Why in front of Ganesha? Ganesha is the most, I should not say, I don't know, but ugly looking physique in every god in this world. Every other god is well built. Beautiful chest, no, the trim tummy. You see Shiva and all best dancers. Krishna, you will see him physically fit, right? But Ganesha is like a old traditional landlord who doesn't work and then sit idle on a easy chair, big belly on the top, where today you can put not laptop, tummy top. They keep their laptop also on the tummy only. Because tummy is like a table, big table, right? How did they get that? Some of the priests in big temples are also like that. I keep asking, are you Ganesha priest or what? And you never did this. I am sure if you would have done this, you will never become. So what is that he says? If you do this, How many times? 108 times. No other exercise is required. That is the best exercise in the world. Otherwise, what will happen? You will have a big tummy. Have you seen Ganesha's picture? Ganesha has got a tummy and that is tied with a snake. And what is the snake shows? Snake shows Rahu in horoscope. Give your horoscope, I will tell you where Rahu is existing in your horoscope in Dasha, which Graha it is there. I can tell you what disease you have, otherwise what disease you are going to get. 100% correct. So far it never went wrong. Your disease can be identified from the place where snake is there in the astrology chart. Snake represents disease, illness, both. It depends on from which place your moon is there, that can cause more disease. Illness 100% with Rahu, which may not be manas, only body. That also is possible. All that can be explained perfectly well. So what is that it says? You do this exercise. So this is Namaskar. So one is Sashtangam, 8 Angas. Second one is touch your feet and touch your elbow. Two types of namaskaras are there. For Ganesha specifically, this is what is given. Because you don't have to do it many times. And third one, you have to take a circumambulation. Because already you have done this in front of Ganesha, you don't have to take too many circumambulation around Ganesha. So how many pradikshinas are given, prescribed to Ganesha? That is also there. I don't know any Sanskrit sloka for this. Because our topic is slokas, I have a sloka for these exercise prescription also. My guru taught me this. Valam gayyal, idam gadum, midam gayyal, valam gadum, etc. etc. It is there. No? With the left fingers, you should cross your right and the right fingers with your cross. Nilam gay muttum, when the floor has to touch this elbow. All that is. Namam Vignam Ganapati. If you do that, you will never have problem with Ganesha's activity. That means you will become very strong. You will be able to do every activity which you want. That is what it says. How many pradikshinas? Ekam Vinayake Kuriyal. Ekam Vinayake Kuriyal. Because already you have done sufficient exercise for Ganesha, you have to only take one circumambulation. One pradikshina is good enough. Egam Vinayake Kuriyal Dve Surye. For Surya, 2. Traini Shankare. For Shankara it is 3. Sometime Shiva temple, Shankara temple, it is not Pradikshina, it is half Pradikshina and Apradikshina. That's how it is. Because traditionally temples were replication of Yagashala. And in Yaga Yatna time, people used to take material inside the place where the sanctum sanctorum sort of a thing. That path is what is given as the Shiva temple. So first temples were not for Krishna, it was for Shiva. So they followed the Yaga Yatna style. Later, when Vishnu temples came, they don't want to follow Shaivism. So they changed this. And now, when you take more circumambulation, it actually energizes the temple. So there is some justification for taking more circumambulation also. Chatwari Devo Vishnuja. For Vishnu, 4. Then Saptaswate Pradakshinam. 7 Pradakshina for the greatest god. You know who is the greatest god? The greatest god is the tree. See, Ganesha has only 1. Surya has only 2. 3 for Shankara. 4 for Vishnu. 7 for tree. Which tree? The biggest tree. Which is the biggest tree? People tree. Therefore, people tree is called Vriksharaja. Why Vriksharaja has got 7 circumambulation? And it also says early morning only you should take a pradikshina. Afternoon, don't take pradikshina. What is the science behind it? That's a normal colloquial practice. Parents will tell, don't run. Don't run means it is not advisable to run. That's all it means. Correct? Don't run, you may fall. Don't take it into English or maybe the normal literary meaning. Don't means I don't advise you to do it. That's what traditional. Right? So don't take a pradakshina means if you take a pradakshina in the afternoon, it is not useful. Morning it is useful. Why people trip pradakshina in the morning is useful but not in the evening? People have done a lot of experiments and found people tree has got a very great scientific ability. It reduces the density of oxygen content in air will become more. Oxygen content in the air everywhere it is not same. More polluted area 16%. You go to my village it will be 20-22%. Not at all polluted. You go to a people tree, it will be 20% guaranteed. So it cleans up. But when you go to Himalayas, oxygen content is too less because of the high electromagnetic radiation, electrical potential is too bad. Even your battery charged here, atmosphere has got a lot of control on the energy concept. You want to know that in normal situation, your phone will work for 2 days. You go to Himalaya, it will work only for half day. Discharge happens faster. That is because of the environment influences the energy potential. That's the physics. So the people tree has got an ability to reduce the density and therefore the flow of oxygen will become much better. But after some time the sunlight comes, the temperature varies around it, the dissipation happens, there is no much benefit going around the people tree in the hot sun or in the afternoon. Early morning, beautiful. That's the best thing. Right? People tree also sleeps. I don't know whether you have seen. The tree leaves, you look at it. Tree sleeps. All the leaves will be lying down. Once it takes rest, don't. Early morning it wakes up. That's the right time where all that photosynthesis happens. Oxygen will be dropped down to you. And you go there and take a deep breath. 100% one circumambulation will not make you tired. With a lot of studi, you keep on taking with chanting. What you should chant there? Mulato Brahma Rupaya. Your root is Brahma. Madhyado Vishnu Rupine. The stem is Vishnu. Agrada Shiva Rupaya. The top portion is Shiva. Vrikshara Jayate Nama. What a beautiful science is this, you see. Mulato Brahma Rupaya, Madhyado Vishnu Rupine, Agrada Shiva Rupaya, Vrikshara Jayate Nama. Keep on chanting this and taking circumambulation 7 times. Why 7? Minimum 7. You can have 70 also. You will become much, much stronger. No respiratory problems, guaranteed. The biggest problem which most of the people suffer in this country especially, is respiratory problems. In the coldest season, definitely they have more. But they do exercise, that's why they do cycling. They go for a long run. I've seen people running every day 8 kilometers. Right? All that exercise is entirely different prescription for different climatic conditions. For us, not required. Just take circumambulation. So people tree has got a great influence on our health. So temple is a place of full of science. Science of life. So good breathing. So how many pradakshina for people tree? 7. What is to be chanted? Around the story of the people tree. Mulado Brahma Rupaya, Madhyado Vishnu Rupine, Agrada Shiva Rupaya, Vrikshara Jayate Nama. While chanting this, will you get extra benefit? Not. But what is the benefit? Because somebody chanted this long, long time back, we are able to remember still that it is our practice. So how do you transfer knowledge? It is not from textbook, I'll tell you. Documents are there that will not give you knowledge. Only when you hear, that is how knowledge comes. Then when you get a spark, you will hunt for knowledge. I am sure if I was not introduced to great gurus, Brahmashri KPC Anujan Patadripad, who taught me all these lokas, not sitting across the table, we were traveling. Wherever we go, he goes, I go behind him. And then I learned lot of slokas. That time I used to have a recorder, recorded everything. And then learned this. Listen that many times. So most of the time when I chant, his old friends used to send me some messages. Even now when listen to my video, you are exactly the same way you are chanting. So the style is good enough. Right? So I still remember. Ekam vinayake guriyal. That's how he chants. Mulado brahmarupaya madhyado vishnurupine agrat. I don't know whether you are noting it. Without knowing it happens like this. This is Jnanamudra. Right? Agradashuvarupaya vrikshrajayate namah. This is how he makes us to make it also like this. So that gives lot of concentration, lot of health benefit. And then go inside the temple, take circumambulation. Right? And then what is generally done? If I remember when I went to one of the temple in Alappi, there are some very specific pujas prescribed. So what I do is, when I ask somebody looking at the horoscope, this is what puja you used to do. If it is very beautiful new style which I never had experienced, immediately I go the next chance to the temple, do the same for me also. So that I can also experience, right? Not because I may have that dosha or no dosha, that's a different matter. But experiencing that is good. So I had one great experience going to one place in Alappi. I wanted to tell this to know the Shastra behind this. It's not science. Science will be proved wrong there. There is a temple called Tiruvida. And most of the temples have become very rich, famous. And if the temple is granite topped circumambulation, then it is the most beautiful. But in the temple can never have a circumambulation place with even stone or granite or cement. It has to be with sand only. That's a prescription. Because you have to walk on sand. While walking on sand, will you be able to walk faster or not? So, I used to prescribe most of the temple should have not granite. What they should have? Sand. And you can imagine hot sun, sand, how it will be. And imagine you are walking in the hot sun. And the cold season also it is bad. But that is not the reason for making sand available there. I'll tell you another reason. The reason is they will give you a prasad in a big bartan, big vessel. And you are supposed to drink that and finish. Don't pour it on the sand and then waste it. You have to drink that. And what is given is poison. The same poison if you drink outside the temple, 100% you will be immediately calling the ambulance and you will have to get admitted in a hospital. But inside the temple you drink, nothing will happen to you. I also drank. And that is prepared as poison for providing for people as a prasada for you to drink. I also took it. And that offering is called Udara Vajibad. Vajibad means offering. What is the offering? Your tummy is surrender to God. So what goes inside your tummy, is it going to your tummy or to God? To God. So will any poison affect you? It will affect you. But will it affect God? No. So with full devotion you take it, nothing will happen to you. And then what will happen? Second circumambulation, third circumambulation, fourth circumambulation, again they will give you same. It will be more than 200 ml. normally you know one dabba which you get that cool drinks and all, no? Like that dabba. But that is given in a traditional vessel. And then you have to drink that water again for circumambulation. How many times? You do it 18 times. And it will be little hot water, warm water. First time poison, the next all warm water. You keep on drinking and walking. Drinking and walking. What is to be done? One contract, previous day you will have to go and sleep in the temple. Don't eat anything. So anybody who does it will have to go and sleep in the temple. Early morning it happens. Do this. Second circumambulation, third circumambulation onwards, you will start vomiting. Because it's poison inside. When poison goes inside, generally what will happen? You will start vomiting. Assume that it is granite top or cement top, what would have happened? Now you know why it is sand, right? So you are supposed to clean immediately after vomiting. What you can do? Put sand on top of it. Everybody, you can see lot of people doing it continuously. And you know who does it? Maximum number of cinema stars goes there to do this. Drishti dosham. If somebody has seen you that you are becoming too famous, too great a personality, and if such doshas are there, this is what is prescribed as a special puja. You see, what a great invention. For even somebody can curse you, there is a cure for that. Can modern science give you such cure? Okay, don't ask me whether modern science believes or not. Whether modern or not modern, everybody has got such diseases and such feelings sometime. Right? If you don't have, you are not a human being. Because what happens around this world influences you. The energy influences. Just now I told you the energy influences, whether to hold it or not. The different thought processes are all energies. If somebody has got a power to give blessing, somebody has got a power to give curse also. 100% it will be there. If you believe in blessing, you have to believe in curse also. I 100% believe in my blessings what I got from my guru. As I see him first time, what I did was I just did my Sashtanga Pranam in front of him. Not even he came to my house. At the gate itself, I has fallen. He decided, yeah, you are my student. It's rare to get somebody doing it. And I have seen him until his last breath. He was always thinking about me. So that is the blessing which somebody should give. That needs your surrendering first. You have seen in Bhagavad Gita also. Arjuna surrenders first, then only Krishna started his lectures. Before that, no. So, what I did was, soon after this was done, until lunch time, you are supposed to sit in the temple. What to do? Just sit. Many people will sit. Describing about all the bad experience they had. I was worried. See, the whole purpose of sitting there is again upavasam, because you are waiting for the food, right? Without the food waiting, what is it called? That is called upavasam. So my guru Brahmasri KPC Anijan Bhattadaripad, he is no more. I met him at the age of 42. We went together to Kailash. Wherever he goes, I keep traveling with him for learning. Even when I was in service, he calls me immediately, I'll go. That's how I learned many things. He also stayed with me in Hyderabad. He came, he visited, he was staying in my house. I took him around for lectures. All that is done. So what is done? Most of the people after the puja, they will sit and then. But what I was thinking is, my blessing of this guru, what gave me this opportunity to experience such things. And he was a tantri, he was a pujari. He was the person who has written a book called Tantra Samuchayam. How a temple has to be maintained, how a temple has to be constructed. There is only one interpretation written for that textbook in Malayalam. That was from my guru. So he was a person who knows how to maintain a temple. So I learned a lot of lessons. So when I was sitting, I was seeing all the lamps in the temple. You have seen most of the lamps in temples, over usage of oil without cleaning. It looks darkish, greenish, not at all clean. So what I did was, I asked for some clothes and I started cleaning it. Because for me, sitting idle is one of the biggest punishment. Immediately the pujari came and said, in this temple, hundreds of people would have come, but you are the only one person who contributed something. Maybe you can put some money, that's a different matter. By your effort and then look. When I started, what happened? Many people who are sitting idle, all of them came. That's what is leadership. You can make a difference. I'm telling you that priest will remember me throughout his life. I'm sure he must have told many people that somebody came like this. Anyway, the priest and most of the people there know me because of my guru's tradition, they know me. That's a different matter. What I did was got some oil, then lighted it. So everyone need have their own way of contributing. So the best method of contributing is do some actions in the temple. Lighting a lamp in temple is part of that. Lighting a lamp in your house is part of enlightenment. It is bringing the light of energy, the sunlight energy, which is the most precious energy. Get it into your house. That is the drishtantam. That is the sankalpa. That is the belief. That is the faith. And that faith has got a lot of science. That's what I wanted to tell you. When there is a light change, definitely electromagnetic energy in the atmosphere will change. Sandhya. Trisandhya. Three sandhyas are there. Morning sandhya, madhyanam sandhya and evening sandhya. Sayam sandhya. All these are sandhyas. Any change in light pattern, any electromagnetic change in the environment can make a difference in your environment inside you and your thoughts can go bad. Early morning, yeah, morning is not good. Finished, the whole day is gone. Evening, the day was not at all good. Then what you will do? Again, you will go to sleep or maybe the activities around is not at all happy. So, what is to be done? Those time, you should light a lamp and look at it for some time. I am sure a lamp, seeing a lamp gives you a lot of inside light. The light is outside but not goes inside. That's what our, which is the most precious sloka which every priest chants. And he chants, keep on chanting. Millions of times he would have chanted. Om Bhur Bhuvaswaha. Om Bhur. Bhur is Bhumi. Earth. Bhuva. Above that. Atmosphere. Bhuvaswaha. All that around it. Om. So when you chant this, remember this. Om Bhur Bhuvaswaha. Tat. Your. Savidur Varenyam. With your light which gets into that. Om Bhur Bhuvaswaha Tat Savidur Varenyam Bhargo. A sun. Devasya Dhimahi. It comes and falls on my earth. Dhi, earth. Throughout earth it comes and falls. Irrespective of the place. Everywhere it is light. No discrimination at all. The biggest, best manager in the world without discrimination, the biggest boss in the world without discrimination, every subordinate is given the same benefit, only sun. So that's the biggest management principle from Lord Sun. Everybody has to be like that. So Om Bhur Bhuvaswaha Tat Savidur Varenyam Bhargo Devasya Dhimahi. But where he doesn't come inside you. Unless you want it, he will not light inside you. Everywhere it is lighted. But inside you it is not lighted. Close your eyes, you will not see anything. What makes you to open your eyes to see the light around what God has given? That light inside you should tell, open your eyes. There are a lot of activities, opportunities around. Who tells me that I have to light the lamp in the temple and clean the lamp? Lot of opportunities are there. But are we looking at every opportunity? No. Who can do that? Only when you are having that light inside you, that creativity inside you. that enlightenment, using opportunity is the success in this life. Many gurus are there, but when I met a guru, I did not leave him. I went behind him learning. That is what the opportunity has to be used. That enlightenment, a chance given, use it. So that is the principle of lighting lamp. So how many lamp is to be given? Not that you have to be in the light. The provider of the light also have to be in your light. So symbolically, when I have a light, it is for me, and the another light is for the sun. So not a single wick. Wick is, don't say that one lamp I put with one fire. No. One fire, even if you put a thread, how many threads are there inside that thread? One bunch of thread, maybe hundreds could be there. Don't count the number of thread inside that big thread. No. That is called wick. That wick is that used for lighting. Actually, what is the light? It is not from the cotton. The cotton is only a medium. What is burning actually? It is the oil which is burning. And which oil you have to use? An oil which will always go upward. See, this is also against science principle. See, you have a lamp, you are putting a thread. But immediately you can see when you start burning, the whole oil goes upward. Is it possible? Anything can go upward? This is capillary motion in physics. Only that oil which has got more viscosity will go upward. See what a great science people learned. Why oil is used and which oil is to be used? With the highest viscosity. Which is the highest viscosity? Ghee has the highest viscosity. How do you check the viscosity of a oil? Keep it in a burthen and then reverse it. Immediately it will not fall. It will think whether to fall or not. Water, when you put it immediately, it will go. Oil, it will, if you put it also, immediately you put it the reverse, nothing, not even a single drop will go out. Water, can you try this? Finished, the time you drop, it goes. Second option, you pour it on somewhere and then try to clean it. Still there is a spot there, that means it is highly viscous. Simple. I am a fluid mechanics man. We learned this property of the fluid as the fluid has memory. That is why when you pour it, it will not go from there. It will stay there. It has got retardation and relaxation. Another fluid which has got this property is the blood within us. The blood, when we stand, it doesn't go down because capillary motion. The small pipes are there, it goes up instead of going down. Otherwise, we cannot stand. The whole blood would have been in our leg. Head would have no blood at all. It is not because of pumping. Whether you are lying down, can you imagine a pump which works, whether it is pumping horizontal or vertical in the same style? That is because the blood has got ferromagnetic fluid with a lot of viscosity. It is called non-Newtonian. Newton said everything will fall down. Some fluid said, I will not listen to you, Mr. Newton. You go and tell your principle to somebody else. I am away from you. And such fluids are called non-Newtonian fluids. If you have not studied fluid mechanics in your life and physics, learn. I am a teacher of fluid mechanics. This is what I teach to engineering college students. This is the same principle used for pumping oil, drilling. Oil is not sucked with the pump. You put a pipe, automatically oil will come out. No pumping up is required. Oil will immediately come out. You need only a hole. That's it. That's how the Bombay High Oil, ONGC and all digging. Right? So oil has got this ability. Which oil is to be used? Ghee is the best. Otherwise, check which is the best one. Till oil is good. So that's why we have got specific purposes. We prescribe this oil is to be used. And how many wick is to be put? How many lamps has to come? Two. Why? One for you, one for me. Joining two. Paramatma and Atma has to join together. God and me. So when you put in the lamp in the puja room, one for Bhagavan, one for you. एकवर्त्यम महाव्याधि यू आर पुटिंग ओनली वन लैंप औरंगाबाद दे प्रोड्यूस्ड वन सिंगल सेंटर वन वाई यू कैन सेव लॉट ऑफ ऑयल देन डोंट लाइट इट एट ऑल नो फुल ऑयल यू कैन सेव एंड दे कॉल इट एस ऑयल सेविंग लैंप आई विल गिव यू ऑयल सेविंग लैंप थ्रो इट आउट इन द डस्टबिन The life itself can be saved. What is the problem? Don't have to. When you do it with the sankalpa. These are all sankalpa. Right? Ekavartyam mahavyadhi. One light only you are lighting. Mahavyadhi. I don't have to explain this. Divartyam mahadhanam. Two lights. Mahadhanam. What is dhanam? Don't think it is money. My brilliance. My knowledge. Which is the biggest dhanam? Bhagavan resides in me. I join with Bhagavan. That is my dhanam. Don't think that money is the dhanam. Dr. TPS has only God Bhagavan inside me. That's it. Good enough. What else is required? When I have Vishnu, Lakshmi will come behind me. When I have Shiva, beautiful sleep, Parvati will come behind me. Shakti will come behind me. Right? When Brahma is inside, creativity is inside, knowledge will come. एकवर्त्यम महाव्याधि द्विवर्तिस्तु महद्धनम त्रिवर्त्यम मोहमालस्यम यू विल गेट मोहम डिजायर अनस्टॉपेबल डिजायर देन व्हाट विल हैपन यू विल बिकम टायर्ड चतुर्वर्त्यम दरिद्रता फोर दारिद्र्यम पंचवर्तिस्तु भद्रम स्याल फाइव इज ब्यूटिफुल वाई बिकॉज इट गिव्स यू ऑल अराउंड लाइट बट The poet who wrote this, don't think this is written by God. It is written by some poet. The poet writes at the last, five lamp special cases when you are really sitting there and then doing the puja, looking at it, you can have five. Otherwise, maintaining five is very difficult. One of them can lit off. Then what will happen? Daridram will come. That means you are not there. Daridram in time. Most just now we started the class itself by saying, everybody have Daridram. You know what is the daridram? I don't have time, I don't have time, I don't have time, I am very busy. That's the biggest daridram. Time is the biggest asset in your life and you don't know how to utilize it, you will become daridram. So that is why it is said for daridram. It doesn't mean physically daridram, understood? You have no time for even to look at the light which you are lighting and you don't have time to enjoy it. What else daridram? It's a full daridram. You understood? Panjavartistu badram syal. Five is most beautiful. Chaturvartyam daridrata. Trivartyam mohamalasyam. Oh, you wanted to light it, but you have no time. What will happen? You will become tired. Keep on looking at it, going and looking at it, and coming and back. You will become tired. Eish. It's not 20 minutes. After 20 minutes, I have to light it off. Who is going to check your time? It's you to decide when you wanted to light it, when you want to light it off. So he says, Divartyam Sushobhanam. Two is good enough. So don't take the literary meaning of these lokas. There is a principle which is associated with that. When you do puja, when you light a lamp, you should have sufficient patience, sit around it and do some bhajans. It is not lighting and going and then doing, seeing the serial. Yeah, I have done. Every day I used to light lamp in the temple and still no. Bhagavan is not, you are not looking at him, yeah. You should have patience. Understood? That's essential. I'll tell you, in Thrissur, one of the senior most professor, who doesn't belong to Hinduism, most of the time non-Hindus will listen to our words much careful than the stupid Hindus don't listen sometimes. I have no religious practices. When he came, I said, what you should do is, you need little bit of concentration. Because he has done a small mistake. When he was arguing with a sub-inspector, no. Superintendent of police, he caught the superintendent of police collar and then beaten him. That's a small mistake for which he got a punishment. So, he came, why I am getting angry like this? So, I said, for anger, there is a beautiful mechanism. What is required is patience. What is the patience? Every day evening, you must light lamp at 6 o'clock. Up to 6:30, sit in front of the lamp, don't do anything. Because I cannot ask him to chant mantra, Rama, Rama and all that. So just look at it for some time. See that five wicks are being burned every day, carefully for 20 minutes. Four means finished. That's the end of you, I said. What he does, he will look at it, he keep on. And I said, equally it should light. He became very good boy after 18 days. Not boy, he was 45, 50 years old that time. I was only 30, 35 or 38. People do it. And one day he called me and said, urgently I have to go out somewhere. I will not be able to light lamp today. Is there any other problem? I said, no problem. The 18 days can be extended to 40 days. That's good enough. He did it. They genuinely do it. I remember when I went to my Himalayan meditation master Swami Vedabharati first time to visit, I found one lady. Only one thing my guru used to teach. Swami Vedabharati, Swami Rama. Meditation master for your sake. But for me, it is Samadhi master. Not even Samadhi. He teaches only silence. Silence master. What do they teach? How to keep silent. So you go to the ashram. Immediately entry prescription. One small pass you will get in which your entry time is written. And prescription is silent for next 3 days. You are going into a place which is not known to you, sometime alone, and then 3 days you should not talk to anybody, but you will have to do many things in that life, right? How can you be silent? Yeah, you can write it and give it to somebody. That somebody else also will write and give you. Can you imagine an ashram where only written but not talking? Have you ever done it in your life? For last how many years you are living, have you become silent for one day? Check. Most of the violence, the solution is silence. Simple. Bhagavad Gita is also violence to silence. I have seen people, 3 days they stayed. By mistake they spoke to somebody. Then the chit will come, 18 days prescription. After 18 days in between, 17th day evening you spoke, 41 days extended your life. Silence. I have seen people staying 400 days also then. More than a year. After this silence, clearance is given, then only you can meet Swamiji, my guru. Otherwise, you cannot meet him. First, you learn silence. Then you come and meet me. That is the prescription given to some of them. Not all of them. I got a direct entry. Right? Some people get direct entry. Some people need this prescription. And where was that lady of 80-year-old lady came from? Netherlands. Just for meeting Swamiji for some time they came, but they stayed for 400 days to get an appointment. So, for some people, prescriptions are silence. One of the silence method is, when you light a lamp, you have to be sitting there and then be silent. That is what is required. Not need of shouting. But if you have a lot of people around you, where they, you have to teach them some slokas, that is the right place. Right? So, Shubham Karodi Kalyanam Arogyam. Then, somebody said Dhana Sambada. Or it can be Dhyana Sambada. Whatever you want, you can add. I keep changing some of the slokas. That's my problem. Somebody says Dhana Sambada. I will say Dhyana Sambada. What you want is Dhyanam. Somebody want Dhanam, that also is fine. Deepa Jyotir Namostute. Namaste to Deepam. Kalyana Namagaram Kalmashaknam Gandhidudandagaram. So many slokas are there. For the light, I am sure there will be hundreds of slokas. Om Asatoma Sadgamaya Tamasoma Jyotirgamaya Mrityorma Amrdam Gamaya Om Shanti. Don't say Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. That is calling Shanti only. No. Om Shanti, Shanti. The last should be silent. The idea of Shanti Mantra is to make Shanti. If you look at some of the temple priests, they are calling Shanti. It looks like he is scolding his wife. Shanti. Right? So, chanting has got lot of meaning inside. If you don't understand the meaning, chanting will become useless. Right? Kalyana Gamraga. Kalyanam is what? I keep making a lot of jokes when I give public lectures because you are seeing people around me. I keep, when I go for corporate training, generally I will ask, how many of you are happy? Everybody will give. How many of you are married? Immediately they will raise hand. So married people are not happy or what? The unmarried people raise their hands. So what is generally in South India, marriage is called Kalyanam, right? So when somebody asks, Bhargavi, Kalyanam aipoyinda?
I
put Kalyanam ante enti?
కళ్యాణం లాంగ్వేజ్ ఇస్ కళ్యాణం ఇస్ మ్యారేజ్
నో కళ్యాణం అంటే సంతోషం కళ్యాణం అయిపోయింది అంటే ఏంటి
ఫినిష్డ్
సంతోషం అయిపోయింది అంటే రైట్ దట్ ఇస్ ట్రూ ఇన్ ఎనీ లాంగ్వేజ్ ఎక్సెప్ట్ ఇన్ తమిళనాడు దే విల్ ఓన్లీ సే కళ్యాణത്തിൽ ఇరుకరుద ఐ యామ్ ఇన్ హ్యాపీనెస్ ఐ యామ్ ఇన్ కళ్యాణం You understood? So what we have done is we have taken half from Tamil and then added our I point. So don't tell. Kalyan I point da? Say no. I am in Kalyanam. Got it?
Yes, sir.